Hi, welcome to the Neville Bardos Syndicate Report for December 2013. Well guys, Neville's come back into full work pretty well at the end of October. October and November, we were sort of just pottering along a little bit, lots of jogging, light dressage, and from December onwards we've sort of stepped it up a bit. We've started his fitness program, which included the long trot sets and some of the canter works. I've jumped him a couple of times. I haven't jumped him too much just because I'm trying to minimise the trauma to his legs in this early stage of his comeback. But you'll see him, I jumped a couple of small fences today at Merry Hazards, which I've got on the video. Obviously, we had a pretty disappointing year this year with Neville being on the sidelines for most of the time. So we're not going to be asking for anyone's money up their maintenance fee up front in January. I want to see if he actually holds together and can string a few events together. And if he looks like he's showing some promise in that department, then maybe you guys could forward your maintenance fee after this point. We're sort of at the point with Neville where I feel like we're at the last hurrah. I feel like he's feeling great. I'd like to really have a good crack at Kentucky because I think he's got a little bit left in the tank. However, if he's not feeling like he's going to hold up, I think we should all start talking about winding the syndicate up, maybe relocating him and putting him with a young rider, putting him sort of in semi-retirement here where the kids that work for me can ride him, or throw him in a backfield, or if one of you guys want to take him on and play around with him. Anyway, I think we should cross that bridge when I get the feeling he's at that point. At the moment, I'm energised and on a mission to try and get him up and running and getting him back to his form that we saw in 2010 and 2011. With his training, I've just been ticking him along, like I said. I've tried not to drill him too hard in the dressage and just trying to get him fit and hardened up. And I think I'll start him in Aiken in his first event, just in a preliminary, step him up to an intermediate, then a couple advanced leading into Rolex. So, fingers crossed, I'm going to do everything in my power to make this come off. And if it's not to be, it's not to be. So, thanks everyone. Merry Christmas, and looking forward to catching up with a lot of you next year in Aiken.